Fishin'Affliction. Hello.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin'Affliction time. For those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grab the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and the big dog's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah. Yeah, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Hey, I'm Hot Depot, and I've got that fishing affliction.
Hi, I'm Denny Brower, and I've got that fishing affliction.
Hey, I'm Mark Menendez, and I've got that fishing affliction.
I'm Bobby Lane, and I got that fishing affliction.
Hi, I'm Chris Lane, and I got that fishing affliction.
I'm Shaw Grigsby, and I got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy, here, fishy, fishy.
Maddie says she wants a new teammate.
Maddie, do you want a new teammate?
No, thank you.
Oh, hey. Hey, Maddie, right here. That's right here. Give me. That's what I'm talking about.
Well, folks, it's time to wet a line because it's Fishing Affliction time, and welcome into today's show as we continue with part two of our fun fishing episode with the big dog, myself, and a whole bunch of friends of Fishing Affliction TV, including Michael Murphy and his sister Madison Murphy, a little girl who has such an inspirational story. And I know you're going to enjoy spending time with these two young children as much as we did doing a little fun fishing. Our Fishing Affliction product spotlight will be on the extremely useful and valuable lure retriever from Fraybill. And don't forget to head on over to our online store there at fishinaffliction.com for all your FATV goodies. And you can watch your favorite episodes of Fishing Affliction there on our YouTube channel. And at the end of the show, you'll meet our Fishing Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week. So sit back and enjoy part two of Fun Fishing with a whole bunch of friends who've got it bad, just like we do, right here on Fishing Affliction TV. Well, folks, last week you got to meet Michael Murphy and his sister Madison Murphy. And Miss Madison sure has an incredible story. You see, folks, since little Miss Maddie was about 2 weeks old, she, along with her family, has been dealing with her medical condition that's had her in and out of hospitals, along with numerous surgeries to address this condition that now has come to the point, folks, that she is actually waiting for a heart and lung transplant. That's right, folks, a heart and lung transplant at 11 years old. But folks, little Maddie has a smile on her face and such a positive outlook for the things that she knows she's going to have to face. And when you're around little Maddie, along with her brother Michael, you just can't help but have fun. And we were blessed with the opportunity to take both of these young kids out and do some fun fishing. And that's exactly what we did.
Now do it, Maddie. And bring the first fish in of the day, Maddie. Bring it in. Now, we caught the first fish, did we not? A team effort. So we are up officially, what? 1-0?
Mm-hmm.
I like it. What do we got? We've got a bluegill. All right. Well, he's not a whopper, is he? But he counts, doesn't he? All right, let me get him off the pole. What's the score?
1-0.
1-0. And there is the one. All right. All right, hold the camera. Okay, what we've explained to everybody, Maddie, is the fact that we are looking for schools of fish, aren't we? And we've got a really busy day on the lake, a lot of folks coming through the area, so we get a little bouncy water, but it's not stopped team Dan Maddie from going up 1-0. True? High five. Sweet. What's the score?
1-0.
Actually, it's not. You know why?
Maddie, reveal the facts. Ladies and gentlemen, fish number two. How about that, Maddie? That is a largemouth. What's the score?
2-0.
Michael, what's that score?
2-0.
2-0, I like it. All right. I like it. All right. All right, time to swap off camera skills, ready? Maddie, this is a largemouth bass. And you were telling me that you and your family get to fish Lake Texoma, is that right?
Mm-hmm.
A very famous lake in Oklahoma, right? That is a largemouth. You've seen this before, haven't you?
Yep.
But you ever see one say, I love fishing affliction?
Mm.
Well, you just did. All right, we're gonna put him back. You ready?
Yep.
Caught on a Series 3 XD. This is the special Maddie version of it. And so far, 2 fish. That's awesome. All right, let's do it again.
Maddie, you are the camera girl. Film your brother.
He's got it. Awesome. Oh, he's got a sauger. There you go.
Ew, he's ugly.
Have you ever seen this before? Well, come on over here. We're going to talk about it. Maddie, have you ever seen this?
Uh-uh.
Can you see that toothy critter? Look at the mouth. Look at the teeth. See the teeth?
Ooh.
Oh, yeah. That.
He's Michael. Ugly.
Ugly?
Yeah.
You know, for some people, this is a beautiful fish. It's a beautiful fish to me, and let me tell you why. This is a sauger. Very prized fish in these neck of the woods. Don't normally catch them during this time of the year. In other words, people don't target them, but you can see they have teeth. And you don't ever want to, you know how you need to hold the bass with your thumb? Well, you don't do that on these. This is probably not a keeper. What I need you to do, I'm going to take your pole, but behind you is some pliers. How we doing?
Good.
Pretty good? And how's your camera skills? How would you rate your camera skills at this point?
7.
7 out of what, 10?
Yeah.
7? My camera skills ain't even a 7, Maddie. The big dog's camera skills, my fish handling skills, what would you give me on that? 1 or 2? Don't say it, Maddie. Don't say it.
8.
All right. I knew we were a team. All right. Congratulations, Mike. That's your first sauger, buddy. That is good. But they do have a lot of teeth. This is a dandy fish right here, too. And you're throwing a Strike King 3XD. That's the same bait that your sister been catching. How many have you caught, Maddie?
2.
Maddie, did we count sauger?
Yeah.
We did, don't we? Okay. All right, so they got 1. You take your pole. Maddie, watch out. There he went. That was good, wasn't it? Did you see that?
Yeah.
Hey, give me some right here. Give me some right there. That fish almost got away from us, didn't it? That was something. Was that? Do you ever see that kind of fish release in Oklahoma? You're shaking your head no. All right, folks, we're going to show you how to release a sauger one more time. First, let them squiggle in your hands real good. Then let them get way up in the air. And then guide them back down in the waters of Old Hickory Lake ever so gently. And folks, all of that action was caught by our 11-year-old camerawoman and producer, Miss Madison Murphy, who's running the Maddie Cam. Folks, I hope you're enjoying this fun fishing episode with Maddie and Michael and the big dog casting in the background as we're doing some fun fishing in the wilds of Old Hickory Lake. And in a moment, we'll be right back. But speaking of in the wilds, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Well, folks, the summertime heat hasn't stopped Nick Malincore from being able to catch some really big largemouths this summer. And here is another 7-pound Percy Priest giant. Great fish, Nick. And folks, this is Brendan Binkley. And folks, that is an absolute monster largemouth. And here are 2 giant smallmouths. And not to be outdone, here's John Big Daddy Wilkerson with 2 massive largemouths and a pair of smallmouths that are showing off their beautiful colors. Thank you for the pictures, guys. Folks, you can send us your pictures to pics@fishandaffliction.com or leave them there at our Facebook page, and maybe you'll see your pictures right here on the big screen.
In the Wild. Your pictures in the wild.
You know, I love to fish crankbaits. I'm always looking for that edge. For years, I've looked for that special crankbait, that one that has that really unique action that really catches the fish. The 1.5 and 2.5 to me are really special. It was a hard job to build it into everyone, to get it that searching type, erratic motion out of it, but we nailed it. You can't believe the action of these baits. The KVD 1.5 and 2.5 helped me win my third Angler of the Year title. The KVD 1.5 and 2.5, money in the bank, baby.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
As a vessel operator, it's important to learn and know the navigational aids on the nation's many waterways.
These navigational aids mark the navigable channel and known underwater hazards. They also indicate where operational restrictions exist and provide general information. Navigational aids are typically found on buoys, but may sometimes be found on signs.
Before you head out on your next boat trip, be sure that you educate yourself on the navigational aids located on the waters that you'll use. It could be a life-saving decision.
The Turn and Trail, for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM, Smyrna Readiness. Serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Folks, here's the tournament trail results from Mike's Thursday night tournament there on Percy Priest, held on July 12, 2012. In first place with 8.56 pounds, the team of Ricky Orton and Jeff Weaver. In second place with 6.35 pounds, the team of Rodney Johnson and Kevin Meeks. In third place with 4.55 pounds, the team of Josh and Bud Cagle. And in fourth place with 4.03 pounds, the team of Luke Lackey and Jackson Morris. And now let's catch up on the tournament trail with Mr. Toby Lillard, Fishin'Affliction contributing angler and United States Army veteran.
Hey everybody, Toby Lillard here. Today we fish American Bass Angler in 32 tournament on Kentucky Lake. I had 5 fish run the floor, 12.85 pounds, good enough for second place win. My fish today came from Battlehead Gym, dipped from the Fire King Little Frog Nerve, and Strike King Square Bill Crankbait. We'll be right back here next week for another ABA Division 32 tournament. Now back for more Fish in the Trail.
Well, good luck to all the anglers out there on the tournament trail, and thanks to SRM for sponsoring the tournament trail. And like Toby just said, now back to Fishin' Affliction.
You take your pole. Maddie, watch out. There he went. That was good, wasn't it?
Folks, welcome back to Fishin' Affliction and our fun fishing episode part two with the Big Dawg and the brother-sister team of Michael and Maddie Murphy. Now, Michael, folks, he's in the ninth grade, he is an excellent student, and he's on the varsity baseball team and loves fishing. And, of course, his younger sister, Maddie, well, she's been on an incredible journey, folks, with all of the issues that she's had to face and the fact that she's waiting for a heart and lung transplant. This little girl displays the positive attitude of determination that we all should have when we face adversity. And she is not letting any of these obstacles stop her from doing the things that she's blessed to do and that she loves to do. And one of those things is singing, folks, and that's one reason she was here in Nashville, Tennessee, as she was performing at the world-famous Bluebird Cafe and also had a wonderful visit at our Grand Ole Opry. And here's Maddie to tell us about her latest adventures, as only Maddie can tell us.
So what songs did you sing last night?
Scars that I wrote, and then When I'm 25.
And how did it go over?
Good.
The Bluebird Cafe. Listen, I've been here for 20 years. I've never played the Bluebird Cafe. So the people liked it?
Mm-hmm.
Now tell me, you were just a little nervous, weren't you?
Yeah.
How come?
Because there was old people.
Old people? How old were the old people?
Like
20. 30?
Maybe 40.
40? Oh no, you mean ancient people, Maddie. Goodness gracious, I'm surprised that we're even able to get around. But you had it fun. That was a good time. And then where did you go? You went to the Ryman Auditorium.
And what did you get to do there?
We got to watch like the new stars.
And who was there?
Like there was a guy and he played this like
harmonica?
Yeah.
Yeah. Was it good? Was there any ancient people there? 40 or over?
Larry Gatlin.
Larry Gatlin, you know, he's one of the greats of all time. Did you enjoy it? So tonight, you are going where?
To the Grand Ole Opry to watch Rascal Flatts play.
And who else is going to be there? Anybody else?
Lauren, Elena.
Okay.
And
then a bunch of old people?
I don't know.
You know, 40 is not necessarily overly old. Now maybe 140, maybe. That's good. Now how old are you?
I'm 11.
You're in the fifth grade.
Mm-hmm.
Good. And how long have you been on your journey right now?
Since I was 2 weeks.
2 weeks? Wow. Well, a lot of folks have been praying for you. And how are you feeling?
Great.
And you've got enough sunscreen on today, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
You've got your striking hat, you got your brother in the front, the big dogs in the front. Are they catching any fish yet?
Mm-mm.
Not yet, but we're the team in the back of the boat. The team in the front of the boat hasn't got any fish either, but we're fixing to get on it, aren't we?
Yeah.
There's two baits on the ground. Which one should we use?
This one.
And how come?
Because it works.
I like that. I like that. Now, you've been co-hosting a fishing show for how long?
A day.
A day. And you already know what baits to use. I like it. Give me some. Good call. That was the one. You know what that's... Do you even know what that's called? All right. I'm going to have to show you how to be a TV personality. Ready? It's a Strike King 3XD. Ready?
Strike King. 3, 2, go. Strike King 3XD.
Made by the number one bait manufacturer in the world. Ready? 3, 2.
Made by the number one manufacturing bait in the world.
Is it a question or a statement?
Statement.
So why does it have a question mark at the end of what you're saying? Ready? One more time. Striking.
Striking.
3XD.
3XD.
Thumbs up in front of your face so I can see it. That's it. Perfect. Now, I had you put him in the water because it happened so fast next to the boat, didn't it?
Yeah.
Well, congratulations. You've got a white bass there. Is that a white bass, big dog?
That is a white bass.
How about that? Okay, well, listen. We are going to get this off for you.
And I think that tied it up, didn't it?
No, because the first one. Maddie, that tied up? 2-2? Maddie's saying no. I think you have to have the fish on like at least 20 feet away from the boat.
You're making up your own.
We are. All right. You going to be a camera guy for a second? Hold it right there.
Well, folks, I hope you're enjoying this fun fishing episode as much as the big dog and myself are, spending time with Michael and little Madison Murphy. And when we get back, folks, we're going to meet a couple older kids who love to do some fun fishing, too. But right now, let's head upstairs to the kitchen to see what Miss Vicki Porter's got cooking this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter. Today's recipe is inspired by my experience at a local restaurant who's known for their excellent lettuce wraps. And here's my variation of lime shrimp lettuce wraps. And now for the ingredients. You will need lime juice, olive oil, soy sauce, grated ginger, minced garlic, shrimp, water chestnuts, iceberg lettuce, carrots, cucumbers, and rice noodles. First, in a bowl, mix together your lime juice, your olive oil, soy sauce, ginger, and garlic. Now pour this mixture over your shrimp. Get it all mixed together and put this in the refrigerator and let it marinate for about 30 minutes. Next, cook your water chestnuts and your carrots in a little bit of olive oil in a skillet for about 3 minutes. Next, add your shrimp and add a little bit of soy sauce and continue cooking this for about 3 more minutes. Now add your shrimp mixture to the lettuce with a little bit of the cucumber and some noodles and roll it up. Put a little ginger on the side and get ready to sit down and enjoy these lime shrimp lettuce wraps. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the skillet.
Oh, it won't be all that long before you waterfowl hunters get to get out and do a little hunting. September the 1st will be the first waterfowl season in Tennessee when we open it with the Canada goose season, the 1st to the 15th. You can go out a half hour before sunrise on that day and have you a good time hunting geese. We'll talk more about that as it gets closer. That's also the same day, September 1st, that dove hunting opens. Only dove hunters have to wait till noon. September the 8th to the 12th will be the first hunt for wood ducks. It's the early wood duck season, always a lot of fun. The one thing you need to remember, the thing that's coming up real quick that I talked about last week, is the annual waterfowl blind drawing. That's 1 week from today. It's next Saturday, August the 4th. Starts at 7 a.m. The getting in line starts at 7 a.m. At 10 a.m., they're going to draw for blind positions all over much of the state, particularly Middle Tennessee and West Tennessee. Go to tnwildlife.org. There's probably going to be 8-10 sites where there's going to be blinds drawn. Take your friends with you, because if your name doesn't get pulled out of the hat or whatever they're using to draw to pick you to hunt in a blind, your friends might, and then they can sign you on to hunt with them in that blind, and you'll have control over it over the whole duck season. So check it out, tnwildlife.org. If you've never been to a TWA blind drawing, the guys usually have a good time, and it's usually very hot, so take some water with you too. We'll see you next week right here on Fishin' Affliction.
On today's Fishin' Affliction product spotlight, I want to talk to you about the lure retriever from Fraybill. This thing is worth its weight in gold. This thing will extend to about 18 feet, folks, and let me just tell you what just happened. This is a KVD, 1.5, probably about a $6 bait, and look what it was in. And if it hadn't been for the Fraybill lure retriever, I would have never gotten this bait back. There's all kinds of line, there's all kinds of twine, and I was able to get it out because of this great tool to have. Needless to say, they pay for themselves just after a few baits, and they are worth having them in your boat. So, pick you up a Fraybill lure retriever and save some money and save your baits. And now back to Fishin' Affliction.
Welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by U.S. Reel, when performance means everything. Aris Rods, don't follow, lead. Cigar Line, always the best. Mustad Ultra Point Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets, keeping you there. Fraybill, trusted gear since 1938. Blakemore's Reel Magic, the name says it all. Deca Gel Batteries, Stay in Charge Battery Charging Systems. Rugged Electronic Mounts provided by Ram Mounts. Lowrance Electronics by BBGMarine.com. And Tournament Wear, look great, feel great, do great. Well, folks, we do a lot of fun fishing with a lot of friends of Fishin' Affliction TV, and I want you to meet a couple of the older kids that you're going to be meeting on some future episodes of Fishin' Affliction TV. You'll be meeting Mr. Andrew Hendrick, who will be getting into a boat for the very first time and also catches his very first crappie on that trip. You'll also be meeting Mr. Mike Pelez, one of the dynamic singers for the Mystery Cowboys, a classic country and rock and roll group that plays here in the Middle Tennessee area. And folks, you need to check them out on the internet because they are awesome. And finally, you're going to meet Mr. Poche Noel, the winner of the Host Your Own episode of Fishin' Affliction TV contest that we had late last year. Now, Poche is a veteran of the United States Navy, and like young Madison Murphy, he has an incredible and inspirational story that I know you're going to enjoy as we do some more fun fishing on some future episodes of Fishin' Affliction TV. And speaking of fun fishing, let's see what's going on in the boat with the big dog, myself, Michael, and little Madison Murphy.
All right, Maddie. You got the hot hand. Does he have the hot hand, Maddie?
Yeah.
You weren't too enthused for your brother. Now, how come? My understanding, pretty competitive when you guys
I'm
get
losing.
In the boat. I know it. No, we're not.
Yes, we are.
You just got to do some Maddie math.
No.
I mean, we could take a lead right now with this fish if you want to, because I am officially holding it, right? But he's officially casting. All right, let's follow the fish. Ready? What's the score?
All right.
What's the score?
3-5.
Do we have 5?
No.
No, we don't, do we?
Where is Maddie's other bait at, the little bait?
We're throwing it.
A little bitty bait?
Yeah, we're throwing a little bit. What do you need?
Maddie says she wants a new teammate.
Maddie, do you want a new teammate?
No, thank you.
Oh, hey. Hey, Maddie, right here. That's right here. Give me, that's what I'm talking about. Hey.
Maddie, I guarantee you I can catch you more fish.
Hey, Maddie and I, Maddie, are we not also producing the show? You're running the camera, right? You're the on-air talent. And who's doing the fishing? These guys. Who was the best partner today?
You.
Who's your favorite co-host of Fishin' Affliction?
You.
Can you say it a little more emphatically?
You!
Sell it.
Dan!
That's what I want to hear. Give me 5.
Hey, Maddie. Dan was your best co-host. Okay, here's the rod again.
Whatever, big dog. That's collusion. Plus, hey. All right, now who's your favorite?
Dan Steele.
The big dog, huh? All right. All right, you can put the rod down. You can do the camera.
Well, folks, after a few hours on the water, it was time to get Michael and Maddie back to their parents so they could get ready for that Grand Ole Opry visit. We were blessed to spend time with them as they were such a treat for us to be with, and they had one thing that they wanted to tell you all.
We got that Fishin' Affliction.
Well, folks, I hope you've enjoyed the last two episodes of Fun Fishing with a bunch of friends of Fishin' Affliction TV, along with our visit with Michael and Madison Murphy. And folks, keep little Maddie and her family in your prayers, and we'll be looking forward to catching up with little Maddie here in the near future. And folks, I want to tell you about a special event that's going to be happening on September 15th at Sanders Ferry Park in Hendersonville, Tennessee, and that's the first annual Freedom Ain't Free Fishing Tournament put on by the Vietnam Veterans Association and Fishin' Affliction Television. Here's the website. Make sure you go there and check out all the information about this wonderful tournament that's going to support our veterans of the United States of America. So start making your plans to come and support and participate in the first annual Freedom Ain't Free Bass Tournament. And we'll be giving you more information here on Fishin' Affliction TV and also at our Facebook page. And folks, on the next episode of Fishin' Affliction TV, it's our iCast special show, part one of our adventures down there in Orlando, Florida, as Team Fishin' Affliction attends the fishing industry's largest convention, with everybody showing off their brand new gear for 2013, and a lot of neat stuff I know you're going to want to see, and some friends that I know you're going to want to visit with. So tune in to Fishin' Affliction TV next week, and you'll see.
Tell us a little bit about the exciting stuff that's going on with Strike King this year.
Well, they've got a lot of new product. I've been busy all morning, so I haven't even got through the booth yet, so I haven't got a look at all of it.
This week's Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend is
Daryl Schuster.
And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fishin' Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishinaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin' Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt that Dan and the Big Dawg got it bad. They've got Fishin' Affliction for those who got it bad.
Ooh, boy, look at this way.
27.09. 27.